Wow, that's really fast.
See what else we can find to grind.
Now I got my gloves from Eastwood too. Man, these things are awesome. Got a lot of protection on them too. For fun, I'm gonna switch to this abrasive drum, see how it does. Oh, I gotta bring y'all in for this one. Holy cow. I should have been using that one from the get-go. Watch this.
His lips are just blowing. All right, guys, I wanted to take a second and cover this real quick. I'm sure y'all are seeing all these crazy pieces that I'm going to be putting on this piece. You're probably thinking, man, did he go and have those CNC'd? If you go to your local metal supplier that actually cuts out stuff out of CNC, they'll usually have a junk pile of all the stuff that was left over. Now, like this piece, of course, it didn't come with these holes. I already drilled it out to put steel rivets in. But if you can see this little notch that's right here, that's where their CNC laser started. And then they cut out this oval shape. It was probably a flange for some kind of tool. And then this was the center section left over. So they just throw this in a bin, and usually it's like 75 cents to a dollar per pound. Of course, it gets kind of expensive with as heavy as the steel is, but it's nowhere near as expensive if you went in there and had to have custom pieces cut out with a CNC machine. Same thing with this. I'm assuming they probably cut it to the wrong dimensions. They had a whole bunch of these in a bin. So of course I snatched them up, but I hoard them and I pull them out of my bin whenever I start building stuff like this. And it looks like we really did some cool custom stuff, but just came out of a trash bin pretty much. Thank you.